This morning in the kitchen, we're cooking with 1149. I'm here with Chef Nick Dadona and Chef Vedran Sudar, and we are making scallops with vanilla bean risotto and blood orange gastrique. Mm-hmm. Did I get that all right?
Yeah, you got it right.
All right, so Nick, Vedran, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you.
So tell us about what we're gonna be making and what ingredients we have here.
Well, we're gonna be making vanilla bean risotto, so as far as that goes, we have some arborio rice.
Okay.
We have some Brunoise garlic and shallots, which is just an 1/8-inch dice, a fine dice.
And wait, back up for 1 second. What was the first?
This is arborio rice.
Okay.
This is how we make the risotto dish. It's similar to a short grain rice.
Okay, so it is like that risotto rice, but just
right.
a tad different one to
right.
make sure. Okay, keep going.
Now we have some vanilla bean pods,
mm-hmm.
Some Parmesan, and some heavy cream, which will finish the risotto once it's done cooking.
That sounds nice and rich.
Right. And then we have some beautiful, fresh U10 scallops here.
Okay, and where were those from?
George's Bank.
Nice.
So we take those in fresh daily at the restaurant.
Okay, and what about these items over here?
Those are the items for the gastrique.
Mm-hmm.
We have just sugar, red wine, vinegar, and blood orange juice.
Okay, and that's going to really bring a lot of citrus into this.
Exactly.
So this is like a meal that somebody can have, or is it something like a side dish that you would have?
This would be an entree at the restaurant,
okay.
and it is one of our best sellers.
It
so,
is?
Yes.
Oh, excellent. Right. Oh, I can't wait to try it then.
Right.
Okay, and what is this like something too that's typical of the season?
Yes, definitely. Scallops are definitely good for the summer.
And this type of risotto, too, with the blood orange?
Yes.
Okay. And why blood orange?
Just the acidity goes well with the rest of the dish.
Mm-hmm.
The bottom, we have a really creamy vanilla risotto, so the flavors really contrast. Even the textures with the crispy sear on the scallop and then the creaminess of the risotto.
Yeah, so that makes sense as soon as you say it.
Right.
That's true.
Everything goes well together.
All right, well, it's also an easy dish, too, so everybody can try it at home. Thanks so much for going through the ingredients, and Will's going to be back with you guys in a little bit.
Thank you very much.
Back to you.
That's right. We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Nick is here. Vedran is here from 1149. We are getting ready to start cooking everything. What are we going to do first, Nick?
I'm going to start some risotto here.
Okay.
I'm going to get the pan somewhat hot.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm going to add a couple of tablespoons of butter. I'm going to get that melting down.
Okay.
So I can saute the shallots and garlic. That's the first step for the risotto.
Any secret to making risotto? We've made risotto on the show
a bunch
of times.
There's a lot of secrets. First off, you don't want to brown the vegetables, the shallots and garlic. You want to just cook them until they're translucent.
Okay. Is that just to get like the flavor?
Yeah,
you're just going to
make them a little tender.
Yep.
And then we're going to toast the rice right into the pan before we deglaze with the white wine.
Okay. And really, this is something you got to keep your eye on, because it can go bad really quick, right?
Yeah, one thing when you're making risotto, you always want to constantly stir the pan.
Okay.
You don't want it to stick to the bottom. And once we deglaze, we're going to be cooking it one ladle at a time with the stock, and you want to constantly stir
it. Just keep moving it around.
You got to keep stirring it.
Okay, all right, you're up. What are we doing?
I'm making the gastrique over here.
Okay.
First, I have to make a caramel.
Mm-hmm.
The best thing to do is just let the sugar sit so that when it starts melting, you slowly stir it so that way it doesn't clump up on you.
Right. Now, just so everybody at home knows, are we starting this pan out on high and really heating the pan up before you put the sugar in?
No.
Or you can just...
You can just let it... When you add the sugar, you can turn the flame on. Like I said, let it sit until it starts melting. Then slowly stir it, make sure that it doesn't clump up.
Okay.
Once it melts and it becomes a caramel, I'm going to add some red wine vinegar to it and my blood orange juice, and I'm going to reduce it to nappe, which just means coating. It will coat the back of the spoon.
Okay.
And that is it.
And that'll be the consistency, just so when you put the spoon in, if it kind of like sticks or hangs onto the back of the spoon,
coats it, exactly.
you know it's ready. What's the flavor like of this? Is it something sweet? Is it something tart?
It's a little bit sweet and citrusy at the same time. It goes well with the dish, like we said before, to balance out the flavors.
Right. And you guys know, I told you, I'm not the biggest, I'm not the seafood lover, but this seems like something that you could put with any dish, like a chicken or anything.
Yeah, you really could. The sauce will go well with everything, especially it goes well with the vanilla beans.
With the vanilla bean itself.
Yes.
All right, guys, we are cooking away. Risotto is going to be put on. We're going to get the scallops ready to go in just a little bit. Back to you. We're back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. 1149 restaurant is the place. Nick and Vedran are here, and we're cooking up a storm. We've got the scallops ready to go. Blood orange, and how do you pronounce that?
Gastrique.
Gastrique, ready to go.
Yep.
All right, guys, what are we going to do right now?
Right now, I'm continuing to cook the risotto. I've added a vanilla bean pod in here.
You can really smell that vanilla bean,
yeah,
by the way. The flavor
really
comes
aromatic.
Out. Yeah.
And like I said, cooking a risotto, you want to add one ladle of a hot chicken stock or whatever flavorful liquid you want to use. You know, this is a fish dish. We could use a fish stock if you were doing like a beef with a risotto. You could use a beef stock.
Right.
Whatever you use to cook with, it's going to impart the flavor into the rice.
Okay, and what does the consistency of this have to be like? Does all of that have to...
We're going to cook until the rice is tender, and then the starches from the rice are going to release, and this is going to become really creamy.
Okay.
But like I said, the rice is still a little raw. You can see that the rice itself isn't clear through.
Okay.
That's how you can tell if it's done.
Okay, good. All right, so we've got that going.
Yep.
Okay, we have this next, and you also have the scallops.
Yes, I am reducing the gastrique right now. Waiting for it to get to that nappe consistency. And I'm also getting my pan hot with oil and butter.
Right.
Key to perfect scallops is a really hot pan and the scallops to be dry so that way the outside can crisp up very nicely.
Okay, and the consistency of this that you need, you were saying before that it actually needs to almost stick or coat,
coat the back of the spoon
itself.
Correct.
Right. All right, so we have the scallops here.
We have the scallops. We're going to dry them with the chick's towel.
All right.
Yeah, you want to make sure the scallops are really dry before you throw them in the pan. The moisture will prevent you from getting a nice brown crust on top.
Okay. All right. And as far as scallops, how big are these, and is there a certain size that we should
these
be using?
These are U10 scallops, but I mean, honestly, you can use any size that you want. Nick, can you pass over the salt and pepper, please?
Sure, okay.
Get some tri-mix here.
Thank you.
Salt, granulated garlic, and some ground pepper.
So everything's just mixed
yeah, it's
mixed
just
together
a,
already?
It's a mix that we use in the restaurant for most of our seasonings.
Okay, just makes it easier.
Yep.
So put a little salt, pepper, and garlic on both sides. Make sure you dry them off. So far, so good.
Yep.
You got that.
Put that in there. And now make sure, like I said, pan really high.
Right.
See how the butter is starting to brown nicely.
Sure. And that's actually what's going to give these a little extra flavor and be able to crisper it. And how long are you going to cook these for? Because
we're going to get a really hard sear on them and then finish them off in the oven for maybe 1 minute or so.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a really quick dish.
Quick dish. Easy to make.
Once you cook the scallop well done, it turns very tough.
Right.
It's no good. You want to keep them like medium rare to medium.
Right. For anyone out there who's going to get scallops, what are some of the things we need to look for? That you guys look for in the restaurant when you are able to find a good scallop?
You can always tell by the smell. You know, good seafood has a neutral smell. You don't want to be smelling a lot of
anything that smells fishy or
We check for the consistency in the body of the scallop. Also, like you don't want torn scallops, ripped scallops. They all have to be fairly consistent in size and shape too. So that's what we look for.
All right. So this risotto over here to my left hand side is reducing down.
Yeah, I'm reducing one ladle of stock at a time, and you can see the rice is starting to cook down. Typically, it takes about 20 to 25 minutes to fully cook the risotto.
Okay.
And then once you notice that the rice is where you want it to be, a little bit al dente, then you stop adding stock and just reduce the rest of the liquid out.
Okay.
And then we finish it with a little bit of Parmesan cheese and a little bit of heavy cream right at the end, and then the scrapings of the vanilla bean pod itself.
And when you add that other cream, it's going to give it a little extra creamy.
Yeah, it just gives it a nice creamy texture. Mm-hmm. And like I said, I have some already finished right here. This is what the finished product looks like.
Okay.
And this, you can see, it's not overcooked. When you overcook risotto, it turns like into mush almost.
Yeah, you know what that.
So you can still see the grains of the rice, which is what you.
And that's the consistency that you really want to see.
Right. So this product right here is ready.
Okay.
And then once the scallops are nice and seared, we can just finish them in the oven, then we can start to plate the dish.
All right. While we're cooking away, while these scallops are crisping away on the edge, tell us a little bit about the restaurant itself, 1149. Give us some of the things you guys like to cook there, and where you are.
We're located on Division Street in Warwick. We like to concentrate on local ingredients. And use local seafood, especially for our specials. We also have coming up in 2 weeks Father's Day brunch that you can come visit us if you are looking
to take dad out.
To take dad out
take
on that special day.
And is that something that we need to make a reservation for?
Yes, I would suggest making a reservation. It's usually pretty
busy place.
Pretty busy.
I know. Anytime I drive past that restaurant, it's rocking all the time. So that's a good sign.
Yeah, we have a busy lunch too. And our dinner services have been really busy, so if you want to stop on by for those as well.
Good stuff. All right, guys. We're going to show everybody the finished product in just a little bit. But if you want this recipe right now and you want to make it tonight at home, you can head to our website, WPRI.com, click on the Rhode Show.